Imagine standing at the edge of the universe, looking out into the vast expanse of space. What do you see? Does the universe have an end, or does it stretch on forever? Today we are going to embark on a journey beyond the stars, beyond what our eyes can see, and maybe even beyond what our minds can easily comprehend. We are diving into the concept of infinity and eternity. How big is our universe? Can something truly be infinite? And what does this all mean for our understanding of existence? Join me as we explore these questions and try to unravel the mysteries of the infinite universe. This video takes its outset in Martinus' world picture. Martinus provides an answer to life's big questions and provides a deeper understanding of the universe and human existence. Martinus' work is extensive, encompassing numerous books and symbols he created to illustrate the world picture. His cosmology is not aligned with any specific religion, but it offers a spiritual perspective that aims to complement scientific understanding. One of the aspects of the eternal world picture is about the universe, which we will delve into in today's video. Let's start by defining what we mean by infinity. At its core, infinity represents something boundless and endless. It's a concept that extends beyond any natural numbers or measurable size. Think of infinity as the ultimate limitless state where no boundaries or confines exist. Now you might be wondering, if something is infinite, is it automatically larger than everything else? Interestingly, the answer is no. The paradox of infinity is that it's not about being big or small. These terms don't apply because infinity, by definition, has no limits. It has no size that we can measure or compare. This brings us to a profound concept introduced by Martinus in his world picture. Martinus suggests that the best way to describe something truly limitless is to call it something there is. It's a simple, yet deep expression. The moment we use terms like big, small, good or bad, we are imposing limits. We are defining something in terms of beginning and ends, sizes and qualities, all of which are characteristics of finite, not infinite entities. In essence, everything we experience in our daily life is finite. It has a start and an end. It occupies space, it ages, but infinity, that's a different story. It's a concept that doesn't fit within our usual confines of time and space. To grasp infinity, we need to stretch our minds beyond these familiar dimensions. It might seem challenging at first, but let's embark on the thought journey together. It's simpler than it appears, and yet it opens up a universe of possibilities. Finding infinity in the tangible world might seem impossible at the first glance, since everything around us appears to have a clear boundary and limit. But let's delve into the everyday to uncover the infinite. Consider a simple object. It could be everything, but let's take a vase. At first glance, it's just a finite object. But let's think deeper. If we were to divide the vase into two halves, and then divide one of those halves into two again, and continue this process, we find ourselves on a fascinating journey. Practically, we reach a limit where we can't divide it further, but theoretically, this process of division could go on endlessly. Here in this everyday object, we encounter infinity. The vase, in its physical form, is finite, allowing us to hold and see it, but theoretically, within its very structure, lies the infinite. This leads us to a profound realization. Every physical object we interact with contains this infinity. It's beyond our usual understanding of space and time, existing beyond the physical and mental world that makes up our everyday experiences. Moreover, this thought exercise reveals something intriguing about the nature of size and existence. From the perspective of infinity, all things, regardless of their perceived size, share a common attribute. They contain infinity. This challenges our usual perception of size and scale. So what we see and touch is finite, but hidden within this finite is the infinity. So at least in theory, everything we experience consists of infinity. Infinity is beyond finity, so it must be unlimited in some way, be everywhere, so to speak. It has no limits, but it is there. We have come to something that is not within time and space. Infinity is outside or above time and space. It has no concrete form, so it can only be, as Martinus terms it, something there is. If we try to describe with a form, we are back in time and space and not dealing with infinity any longer. So what does this tell us about the universe? It suggests that the universe in all its vastness might also contain this infinite nature. Just as the vase holds an endless potential for division, the universe might be endless as well. This perspective invites us to reconsider the very nature of existence, encouraging us to look beyond what is immediately visible and consider the infinite dimension that lies just out of our sight. Let's now explore a profound question. Can the concept of infinity apply to the very existence of things? Martinus states the answer is a resounding yes. He suggests that the something there is behind everything in the universe, both the big and the small. Think about it this way. We can keep dividing physical objects into smaller and smaller pieces, theoretically, without an end. But it's not just the small that's infinite. If we reverse this process, theoretically, there could also be larger and larger structures endlessly expanding. This might be harder to comprehend, since our daily experiences are with finite objects that we can see and touch, and we cannot in the same way see bigger and bigger in the endless. Consider the universe itself. As our telescopes improve, we keep discovering more galaxies, stars, and cosmic phenomena, suggesting that the known universe is expanding, or rather that our knowledge of it is expanding. But what if this knowledge expansion is a hint that the universe has an infinite nature? What if there is no ultimate edge to the universe, no final frontier? We are limited in our outreach in the universe as we are in the microcosmos and our outreach into the atomic and subatomic world. There's only so much we can see, but in theory we can already know that it can go on by dividing into smaller pieces. The claim here is that the same applies to the bigger, and bigger that can go on indefinitely. What should end it? A war? Could a void take over? But that void would in absolute term also be something and not nothing. That is the idea here. There is no end to the universe. There is no brick wall that we are hitting at some point. This leads us to the conclusion that the universe is without limits. It's a challenging concept, especially since we're used to thinking within the confines of size and time and defined beginnings and endings. But embracing the ideas of eternity and infinity, as Martinus suggests, can offer us a new lens to understand the world and our place in it. Ultimately, Martinus persists that the key to unraveling the mysteries of life lies in these concepts of eternity and infinity. To find the answers, we have to think beyond the conventional constraints of time and space. I will delve into that in more details in other videos. Throughout this video, we have explored the concept of infinity from a cosmic perspective inspired by Martinus' worldview. But infinity is a concept that also has deep roots in mathematics, where it plays a crucial role. This is where you come in. I'm particularly interested in hearing from mathematicians and math enthusiasts. How do we perceive infinity within the realm of mathematics? are there different ways to conceptualize infinity in mathematical terms compared to how we have discussed it in cosmic terms? Please share your insight and perspectives in the comments below. Your contribution can help all of us deepen our understanding of this topic. Whether you're a math expert or simply someone intrigued by the concept of infinity, your views are very valuable. Your comments and insights might even inspire future videos as we continue to explore and unravel mysteries of the universe and our existence within it. So please don't hesitate to share your thoughts and join the conversation. I'll be reading and responding to your comments, and I'm eager to see the different viewpoints and insights you all bring to this infinite table. Thank you so much for joining me on this journey through this concept of infinity and the vast universe where we are part of. If you enjoyed this exploration and found this video enlightening, please consider showing your support by giving a like. And if you're passionate about unraveling the mysteries of our universe and life, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Your subscriptions not only support the channel, but also ensure you won't miss out on future videos where we'll continue to explore the fascinating topics. Thank you again for watching. It's very, very much appreciated. Until next time, keep honoring the infinity.